basketball today by the Charlotte Hornets. 36 assists. They've scored 113 points, which is about 30 more than they scored for the entire game in their last meeting with Boston at the Garden April 4th. They were held to a season-low 86 points, lost by 30 in that game. It has been a 180-degree difference on the offensive end and on the other end of the floor as well. Oh, Jason Tatum, 5 of 14, up 5 of 15, and Jaylen Brown, 2 of 8 of 22.
Like, there's not much time left in this game, but the Boston Celtics have about 90 seconds left of game time to make an impact and try to shift the flow of this game if they want an opportunity to come back.
36 assists for the Hornets a season high. Brandon Rozier has combined 20 assists and just 3 turnovers.
Yeah.
Wanamaker getting it to go, and it's a 19-point lead matching Charlotte's largest of the day. Meanwhile, Boston has now missed 7 in a row as Walker could not get the layup. And numbers for the Hornets. Graham in the corner. That will do.
Yeah.
Lead up to 22 now with 3:40 to go. Brad Stevens emptying the bench.
Like I said, there was about 90 seconds. If they didn't get stops, you knew that this was going to happen. They were going to just clear their benches and see if they could get, a little bit, get these guys off their feet.
Tatum able to connect on a 3. Timeout here by Brad Stevens. Or is it a foul? Take foul, I guess, to get the subs in the game. Here's Brad Stevens during the last timeout talking to his team.
The way they played all year, they've been unbelievable here. And the pace that they play with is terrific. I mean, they're playing so fast right now.
Complimenting the offense of the Hornets.
If you are a basketball fan, you can't do anything but appreciate the way this team is playing. You got 6-7 guys in or near double figures, ball movements, assist after assist after assist. Not a lot of guys taking 3-4 dribbles. It's just a very, very fun team to watch and probably not a very fun team to play against.
They play hard. They share the ball. Very unselfish. Urging for it to talk about that with Israel Gutierrez in between the quarters about this being a very unselfish team. And he's told us many times that LaMelo Ball has fit right in with that culture. And at 19 years old, LaMelo's all about team, all about sharing the ball, despite obviously having a very famous family and being in the headlines for the last 5 years. I mean, going back to when he scored 70, 80 points in high school games.
That's what.
What was it?
I used to always be enamored when I would see guys do that. Like 60, 70, 80. DeJuan Wagner scored 100 points. I played with a guy in high school, Teddy DuPay, played at Florida. He averaged 40 points a game in high school. Those numbers, they get outlandish when you start hearing those.
Rooted and committed to UCLA at age 13. Played 1 year high school with his brother, Lonzo. And again, LaMelo, you see him working out that right wrist, hoping he'll be back here this week. For the 42nd straight year, the NFL Draft is on ESPN, also on NFL Network, and the College Game Day crew will be on ABC again this year. It all comes to you Thursday, Friday, Saturday, with all 3 days on ESPN Deportes, ESPN Radio, and the ESPN app. The draft starts at number 3, it seems like, with two quarterbacks going to number 2, starting with Trevor Lawrence to Jacksonville. We'll see what the Niners do, who they traded up for at number 3. And Neesmith at the line, gets the first free throw. 39 assists on 35 made baskets. Just remarkable execution by the Hornets this afternoon.
I don't know the percentages. That's for all the stat boys to do, all the analytics guys. But how many times has that happened this season? 120 points, 39 assists on 45 field goals?
Charlotte will go to 30 and 30. And the Hornets have With this game, and after today, they have 9 of their final 13 games at home. They play Milwaukee here on Tuesday. They haven't been a great home team. They'll be just now 4 games above 500 at the Spectrum Center, but then with the expectation that LaMelo Ball is going to be back, and at some point Gordon Hayward returns, they get a chance to make up some ground and avoid the play-in tournament with a lot of these games down the stretch here at home. Meanwhile, Boston will drop to 13-18 on the road. That's their worst home record since 2014. They missed the playoffs that year, Brad Stevens' first year. The next 4 are at home, starting with Orlando on Tuesday, and then these Hornets on Wednesday night. Another 3.
Another assist.
And for assist, that's 40. They tie a season high with the 21 threes. Hornets trailed for only 15 seconds in this game, led by as many as 24, which is their current lead, but now 21 after Boston able to answer with a 3. Don't forget Brooklyn has Phoenix coming up next. That one's going to be fun to watch. Chris Paul, Devin Booker, Kevin Durant expected to play, but according to Malika Andrews, will not start. Missed the last few games for the Nets.
Last time they didn't start, they didn't bring it in until midway through the second quarter. So they really try and, you know, take care of that minute restriction and you know, make sure you can try and end the game.
I know we got to get off the air here, but it is Chris Paul and or Devin Booker in the MVP conversation in your mind.
I know Phoenix Suns hate it. Look, I'm a Phoenix kid. I love Devin Booker, but I think Chris Paul's impact, when you look at the impacts he had in different places, I think Chris Paul would probably be the leader. That's why he got the All-Star nod before Booker.
Final score, 125-104. Boston just 4 of 20 from the floor in the fourth quarter.